Hey guys, it's your girl Jada. Welcome back to my channel. Today, I just want to show y'all how nicely I slayed this 360 lace wig. Like, look at that. No, it's not her real hair. No, it's not. Let's just call a spade a spade. I did an A++ job. Look how natural, guys, look how natural this looks. And I didn't even do too much. I mean, I really did too much, but I didn't do too much. But if you're interested, keep on watching to see how I got the back to look that nice. So I'm using Ronnie hair for this video. I'm just lightening it just a tiny bit because I wanted it to be brown, but it really did not come out as I wanted. But I'm just showing you guys this part just so you know it's the same wig. I'm not tricking you. So I just used 2 Revlon box dyes, and y'all, I don't know if Revlon is just not working as well anymore, but it did not do what I needed it to do.
I just lifted the color a little bit. I really wanted more of a lighter brown, but clearly those box dyes weren't really lifting the colors, but the color is a little bit more brown. As you guys can see, it's not as dark brown as before, and definitely in the sunlight this will be hit in. Okay, all right, so I really wanted to test myself this time, and I wanted to try out like a ponytail, like a real ponytail though. But this is how it's a 360 lace wig, as you guys saw. So it's all lace around. The back part, it could be plucked and put into a ponytail style. The dilemma I'm having right now is that this band that tightens the wig is right on the back hairline, so it's right here, so it won't look natural if I pluck it. So right now I'm gonna have to remove this, which is gonna be sad because this is really the thing that I use to tighten all my wigs. And you can definitely re-sew it on closer to the inside of the wig, but that's gonna be a lot of work for me. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna work with the bands that they gave me on the inside and remove this one just to give it a more natural looking back, because I really want to attempt to put this in an actual ponytail. So that's what I'm gonna really do quickly off camera, because it's gonna take a lot of time. I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna remove the band, and I'll get right back to you guys and show you how it looks without it. So I removed the strap on the inside. As you guys can see, there's nothing there. Y'all, that was so difficult. You have to be very careful because you can get holes in the lace if you're not careful. But right now, as you guys can see, it's pretty lacy and see-through. So my next thing is I'm gonna go in and try to pluck the back so it looks as natural as possible. Y'all know a regular kitchen is always kitcheny, like it's always thin. So we're gonna do that right now. This is probably the second most important part. This is the back part. As you guys can see, it's hella thick. I'm gonna zoom in so you guys can see. What I'm gonna do before I start plucking, it's kind of like plucking the front part of your wig, but not really. I'm gonna go get a spray bottle with water in it. Important. All right, so I got my spray bottle, and what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna spray the back part of the wig so that it's pretty wet. The best time to pluck your lace is when, I mean, to pluck your wig, your lace, oh my God, is when it is wet. So now that it's a little bit damp, I'm going to comb it back a little just to make sure everything is detangled. And what I'm gonna do is I'm going to take some out. This is basically just like plucking your frontal. The knots aren't fully bleached on the back because, y'all, I was not focusing on the back. But I'm just gonna go in like the front, and I'm just gonna start plucking. Okay, you guys feel me? So I'm gonna do this until it is looking as thin as possible. So let's go. Okay guys, so one thing I'm realizing, the back part of the wig is so much harder to pluck than the front. But as you guys can see, I did this side off camera, and this side I have not touched. So I'm just showing you guys how, you know, it's coming along slowly but surely. I'm so tired though. But you know, this is when you pull it up, it looks a little bit more natural. This side is still a little bit too thick. So we're gonna keep going, and then I'm gonna show you how natural the back part looks. Okay guys, so this is as much as I'm doing, y'all. Like, this is a bit too exhausting. So this is how the back looks, and I think this looks pretty good for like where I got it. It's pretty thin, not too thick, as before. I got some holes in it because when I was removing the straps and stuff, it was really difficult. But this is how it's looking. That's how it's looking on my hand. It's not too bad, you know, I'm not mad at it, but y'all, I'm not even gonna go any longer. I'm telling you, this is like so exhausting. I wish it came a little bit thinner in the back. I wish the straps weren't there in the back, because I felt like that was just really an awkward place to put the strap if I was to put this in like a ponytail style. This is how like the side would look. I'm not mad at the sides. It looks kind of natural. The front looks really natural. That's what I really like. Let me give you guys a close up. Yeah, I definitely did that on the plucking in the front. This is how it looks. I really love how it's looking. And the thing about it too is I really hope that it fits the head that I'm putting this on, because that would be a bummer. But the back doesn't look too bad, as you guys can see. Like pinned up. This kind of look a little bit natural though. Yeah, yeah. Quick little disclaimer. I'm not gonna focus too much on the like application and gluing the front down. It's really for the ponytail style and doing the back, because I've never done anything like that. So we're really gonna focus on gluing the back down, positioning the wig, you know, making it look natural. So it's not gonna be like any of my other videos where I like put the three layers down, wait, put the scarf on. I'm really gonna skip through this. I don't want it to be too long, but I want to show you guys how I'm getting this ponytail that I'm attempting to do. So stay with me through this video and y'all are gonna see firsthand if I messed up or if I got it right.
So guys, today I'll be applying this wig on my twin sister because it's easier to do a 360 glue down on someone else. I'm not going to be able to see the back of my head and I won't look like an idiot on camera. But anyways, my sister volunteered and all I'm going to do to begin with this part is I'm going to be pinning up the hair. So after you do that, you could see properly what you're doing. And as you guys can see, the layout is pretty clear. If you miss this layout, girl, go back to the drawing board. Anyways, I'm cutting around the ears just so it can breathe. Why would you glue the lace down over the ears? Okay. Now, after that, what we're going to do is glue it down. Now, I'm going to skip the front part because y'all already know how I glue the front lace down. We're trying to focus on the back. Now, for the back, all I'm going to do is match it up. Now, the hairline in the back, I'm gonna admit it could have been plucked and designed differently, but everybody's hairline and nape of their necks are different. But what you want to do is clean the back part. Do not forget to do that. Don't think because it's your kitchen you don't have to clean it with alcohol. You have to. But I'm gonna be using InstaGlue for this application. I'm doing one layer because my sister is, she doesn't really care to wear her wigs that long, so I'm doing one layer and I'm just gonna put it down. This is kind of like doing the front part of your hair. It's not different. The only thing that's different is where you're doing it. And then you're gonna press it in with your comb. The one thing that I could admit also is on the sides of that, behind the ears, I could have plucked that a little bit, but y'all, I was sleepy. I was so tired. I just gave up. But next time, you know, I know what to do differently. But you know, just glue everything down. And honestly, it does make more sense to glue the sides down before the actual back, but I wasn't thinking. So anyways, just glue everything down. And what you're going to do is go in and press it in with your comb, and then you're going to cut the lace off. It's pretty simple. I know it's going a little bit fast, but as you guys can see, it's not that hard. The hardest part really would be to hide your hair under there, because it can get a little bit bulky. But you know, cut the lace off, and as you guys can see, it's already looking natural. One thing I like about Ronnie hair is that the lace color was not bad. Like, it actually matched my sister and my skin tone. So that's an A++. That's what you want when you're getting a 360 wig and you're gonna glue it down. Make sure the lace matches. And look at the frontal, y'all. Look at the frontal. Look at the front part of the wig. I mean, it looks like her hair. Like, it looks like her hair. The only thing I would say is behind the ears right there, I could pluck a little bit more. But other than that, you cannot tell me that this isn't hers. I mean, like, we could debate. I mean, let's go to the debate club, because this is her hair. Nobody is gonna tell me otherwise. And the thing about it is, all day I kept looking at her like, wait, that's you, but knowing good and well that I did it. But anyways, another trick to making this look a little bit more natural is pulling out some of that, you know, the baby hairs like I did. Pull out some of the hair, cut it like in different shapes and different lengths and stuff, just to make it look a little bit more natural. And she wanted to wear it pinned up for the day, so she did that, and y'all, it did not look horrible for the whole day. One thing though, the lace in the back started lifting a little because I didn't use a lot of layers of glue because we were in the sun all day. But yes guys, this application was super duper easy. The hardest part of this was just plucking and removing that band. Other than that, it was pretty easy, and I love how this came out. If you guys liked how it came out, make sure you give me a thumbs up, and make sure you subscribe, and make sure to comment down below if you liked it too, because I know y'all did. But y'all, these are some pictures I took in the sun. Look how nice and natural that looks. Yeah, what lace? What lace?